Before continuing this video, we will recommend you watch our previous videos, What is Programming and Programming Paradigms. Introduction to Object-Oriented Programming. We are always attempting to use computer programs to solve real-world problems. There are numerous approaches to solving the problem. Object-oriented programming is one of the techniques to solve problems. In reality, the world operates based on object interactions. Consider the television as an example. We need a TV remote to view movies. A power socket is required to power the TV. All three items should work together to view a movie. Object-oriented programming helps us to recreate real-world objects in the computer world. In object-oriented programming, the whole software or program will run depending on object interactions. What is an object? An object is defined as something that can be seen and touched but is not living. But in the world of computers, both living and non-living things are considered objects. In the computer world, everything is non-living. Because we are reproducing real objects on the computer. Example, human, animal, bus, TV, etc. An object will have two parts. The first is an attribute, and the second is a behavior. For example, we humans have various names, foods, and languages. These are attributes. At the same time, we all have common behaviors, such as eating, speaking, etc. In the computer world, we will refer to behavior as methods. Attributes will refer to as data. So the object is a combination of both data and methods. What is a class? Assume you are going to build a house. You will design a blueprint or prototype of the building, right? Here, the blueprint will assist us in building as planned. The blueprint contains all of the building's specifications. A blueprint of the object is required for computers to create an object. Java developers utilize the class file to define objects and their behavior. The computer will read the class and create objects based on it. So class serves as a blueprint or prototype for the creation of objects. Difference between procedure programming and object-oriented programming. As previously said, any program will have two parts. The first is data, and the second is behavior or procedures. In procedural programming, data is separate from procedures. In certain cases, the data is global, allowing for easy modification. As a result, data access is unmanaged and unpredictable. In object-oriented programming, both data and methods are within the objects. Without proper access control, it is hard to alter data. It means that access to data is restricted and predictable.